Barbara, how are you?
Hey, Andrew.
I know you.
You do?
I do. How are you?
Yeah, I tweeted you a couple times. You tweeted back an email and all that.
It wasn't a private tweet. It was a public one. Let's just share that on Bob Turner Day in Anthony Weiner's district.
Yeah. Hey, I wanted.
But what did you think of the picture?
Yeah.
Of my bedhead. Of my famous bedhead.
Hey, I was wondering if you noticed that liberal Hollywood comes out with, of course, these movies about Republican presidents, about their term. But it's I think it's kind of revealing that they don't come out with movies about the Democratic presidents in the past. Now, they do, you know, case JFK is about the investigator of the assassin, and then FDR was about the fair, but nothing about their actual terms. I mean, if they're so proud of it, why not make a movie about it?
Well, when was the last time that right now everybody's looking back at President Clinton, and he did a great speech on 9/11. Give the man credit where credit is due. I don't know if anybody saw that speech, but you can go to Breitbart TV, and you can see President Clinton. I think he gave the best speech, and it seemed sincere. And this is from a person who has a Clinton BS detector, where when he bites his lip, I don't believe it. When he's at the Ron Brown funeral and he's laughing, and then he turns around and sees a camera, and he's able to turn on his tear duct. I don't buy the man as an authentic person per se, but I really do think, perhaps I'm now in the fools category, that he did a magnificent job the other day. But I don't think that, you know, after the 8 years of President Clinton, after what happened in 1998 and the way that he left the office, they wanted him, you know, Al Gore kept him as far away from his campaign as humanly possible. Perhaps he's redeemed himself during this period of time. But when is the last time that a Democratic presidency worked out in a way that Democrats can look back and say, this is a great presidency? And I think you have to look back to a time when Democrats weren't infested by this hard leftism. You look at JFK, whose tax policies and his foreign policy sound like a right-wing extremist today, or Harry Truman, who dropped the bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, a strong, you know, non-isolationist point of view. So you have to. The current strain of the Democratic Party is not your grandma's Democratic Party in the golden age of Hollywood, when Democrats were on the same page with us in terms of what patriotism was. Not that you dissent against the government 24/7 and that you think that America is a force of evil in the world. And that's what we have in the presidency right now, is somebody who thinks that we need a strong cleansing and redemption. Clinton, Kansas, how are you?